So my kids are on a 2-week school holiday and I work from home, which means when they're around at home I can't work, I get super grumpy. My wife doesn't like it, so she sent me away, wet feet, to work. Anyway, so a couple of weeks ago I was at a technology conference in Detroit, Michigan in the States, and I sat on a panel talking about service meshes. So I thought I'd talk about service meshes real quick right now. I'm going to start and finish on the same point, right? So I'm going to start by saying that, I don't know, 1 or 2 years time from now, late 2020, 2021 maybe, we're going to look back and be literally, water again, ashamed that we deployed production applications, microservices, cloud native applications on Kubernetes without a service mesh. So why am I thinking that? So here we go, right? Deploying an application as a microservices cloud native application, let me just show you the scenery as well, on Kubernetes doesn't make your application simpler, it makes them way more complicated. And you know, back in the day when we would deploy applications as monoliths, so all of the different services in the application would effectively be inside of a single binary, we didn't have to care about those different sort of services and features communicating with each other from a security perspective, I mean. But now that we've broken them all out into their own microservices and they're all communicating over a network via APIs, we have got loads of network traffic going around that's potentially unsecure. So by deploying a service mesh, you get to simply and automatically encrypt all of that network traffic. And on Kubernetes with microservices architectures, that is a really big deal because there is a lot of potential traffic out there. Whoa, that's cold. That's a real big attack surface. Anyway, so if you deploy to a service mesh, then you can encrypt all of that service-to-service communication. Also, right, like what kind of telemetry and what visibility do we have against our applications and our application networks? So like maybe what latency is and how saturated the network is. What visibility of that do we have without deploying our applications to a service mesh? Most of the time, the answer is none. We've got freaking no visibility into that. And if you want to go and talk to your senior management or your CIO or whoever and explain that to them, you know, that we've got lots of network chatter going on with our production applications and it's unsecure, and that we have not got a Scooby-Doo or we have not got a clue about telemetry and, like, you know, what I just said there, latency and network saturation and stuff like that. That is not a conversation you want to be having. So what does a service mesh look like? In the Kubernetes world, right, we deploy our applications via pods. And when we deploy a service mesh, the typical model would be to add a sidecar container, a proxy container, into every pod. And that proxy container, intercepts all network traffic coming in and out of the pod. So we deploy our applications, so we package them as containers, wrap them inside of a pod, and then we deploy a sidecar proxy container into that pod that implements the service mesh. So, for instance, you might have application A in pod A talking to application B in pod B. As far as the applications are concerned, they're talking directly to each other. But when you've got a service mesh in play, application A's traffic that is sent to application B's gets intercepted by the sidecar proxy container, or the service mesh, if you will, where it's uniquely situated to pull out all of that telemetry to secure the connection, yeah? So the applications think that they're communicating directly with each other, but they're actually communicating via the service mesh, and the service mesh is adding intelligence. So things like encrypting traffic, giving you that telemetry, intelligent routing based on latency and all that kind of jazz. You can do canary deployments, A/B releases, all of that good stuff. So one of the reasons that we're not doing it now is that it's kind of new and the learning curve is relatively steep. Though if you deploy to some of the hosted cloud Kubernetes services, then it's super, super simple to deploy. But it's getting easier, and I think that in 1, 2, maybe 3 years' time, every single cloud-native microservices application will be deployed to Kubernetes via or on a service mesh. And when we're doing that, we will look back at today and be literally ashamed and embarrassed that we weren't doing it back today. Because I mean, running line of business production, business critical applications, you know, all the important stuff, without encryption, without observability and visibility and all of that kind of intelligence, just crazy that we ever did it, okay? Anyway, listen, I'm Nigel Poulton. This is your Kubernetes moment for the week. Subscribe to the channel, and if you're going to KubeCon, see you there.